Welcome to The Advocate, a program that thrashes out all the topical issues of the day.
When you are in government, you don't see nothing wrong with exactly. Whatever is happening. The moment you are out there, everything is wrong.
You can't even see many women now, and when they're there, they're not even really making a mark, and then they have an NYSC problem and this and that.
One of the reasons why we don't have more women in politics in Nigeria is for as long as political meetings continue to take place in the middle of the night.
Exactly.
Yeah. No, really. It's disastrous for a president to even say to be unaware of the chief
justice. It's a ploy. It could be a strategy.
That strategy was a terrible strategy. Because the buck stops at your table.
Whether it's that we don't look after our cities, and quite frankly, Nigeria has become in a very ugly place.
When you are the only one feeding the people with this news, and there is nobody countering them, it becomes, the news.
You are watching The Advocate on Plus TV Africa. Time to bake a bigger cake. There is an African saying that sharing two chicken drumsticks amongst three elders is a difficult assignment. This is what has become of a country like ours and its budgeting. By my estimate, Nigeria, with 200 million people and huge infrastructure deficit, needs at least an annual budget size of about 150 trillion to fire its turbines on all cylinders. It should not be surprising that sharing 10 trillion has become such a Herculean task. Let me drive my point home by comparing the two largest economies in Africa. Number one is Nigeria, followed closely by South Africa. As of June 2019, when I did the numbers, South Africa, a country of less than 60 million people, proposed a budget of 44 trillion naira equivalent for its 2020-21 year. Nigeria, with 200 million people, struggles with 10 trillion naira. Do not say I told you. The education budget for South Africa's central government for 2020-21 is about 10.7 trillion equivalent. And that is more than the size of the entire cake that the federal government of Nigeria is bringing to the table. Let's do a little extrapolation. Simplistic as it may appear, it should get us thinking. If the central government of a country of 60 million people posts a budget of 44 trillion naira, how much should the central government of a 200 million people country post? The answer is 147 trillion, ceteris paribus. However, when we consider the fact that South Africa is light years ahead in infrastructure, then even our 147 trillion begins to look inadequate. We have a revenue problem, and this disease is breeding symptoms such as unsustainable debt, poor infrastructure, pervasive poverty, and other ailments. I want to advocate that while we committedly manage the symptoms, we must not lose focus of the disease. For the disease, revenue is the root of the symptoms. Come along with me. Let's make some noise to let the government know that we must bake a bigger cake, a much bigger cake.
We must bake a bigger cake. The only problem is, where are we going to get the ingredients from, That's the thing we have to look at. From what I understand, they're trying to get the ingredients from us, and we don't even have much of a cake. We don't even have the stuff. So they're taxing us to high heaven. And I don't know whether, everything, the bigger cake, really, according to your advocacy, will probably only come from more borrowing. Which is,
not
you don't think so?
Not necessarily.
Do you know, I read yesterday that we had reached, what was our debt has reached, is it 23 trillion?
Yeah, it should be in that, something. It should be in that neighborhood.
And basically, a lot of it has happened in the last 3 years.
Oh, really?
Yes. Yeah. So all this borrowing that we're doing, and this is how we're getting the bigger cake, quite all right. Yeah, another thing I noticed yesterday I read about was that, I don't know how many of us have applied for our national identity cards, right?
Okay. I have.
And until today, we have not received the cards, even though we might have gotten the slip.
Yeah.
And then I read yesterday that the reason why we haven't gotten the card is because we don't have the money.
There's no money.
To get the card.
Really?
Yes. And now they're even charging for replacement cards and everything. if you ask me, from everything I have seen around, Nigeria is broke. I don't believe Nigeria is solvent in any shape.
This is where I'll come in, because I think, you know, I'm glad she said where are the ingredients.
Okay, please
because,
come in.
Yeah, I'm flowing with you in the sense that clearly it's taxation. Mm. I did hear you say something, you know, recently, which that we're one of the least taxed countries, you know, when you compare with countries like the United States, where, and even the UK, they can tax you up to 50%. But I don't even mind being taxed if I were seeing the dividends, because there at least you're getting your light, you're getting your water, you're getting your, so you know why you're paying your tax.
Right.
But not when I'll pay tax, I have to police you as well. I have to make you accountable to me. And if sometimes you act as if I have no right talking to you at all.
Sometimes.
At least over there, the language is I pay my taxes, so I'm entitled to hold you accountable. Here, you pay, but they want to now dictate to you and behave as if you can't talk to them, like a dictatorship. I'm sorry, they're not ready, because, and then you're still talking about, you know, outrageous sums when it comes to the legislature's income and their living allowances. They're not inspiring us. So I'm happy. I also heard you talking about how they're dealing with travel allowances, ESTA codes.
Correct.
Let's see. It's a proclamation at the moment. Mm. Let them begin to pull back. I think they need to set themselves to lead by example, finally.
Correct.
Pull back on your expenditure. Show us that you're living a much leaner lifestyle before you even talk of increasing taxes, because people will not, unless you're going to come and pull it from my bank account by force. People are more likely to rebel against that, because that's the only way they can let you know that we don't trust you with the little you have. Because
I wish people would rebel against it, but I have a feeling people have been so browbeaten, this time that they will just, we're accepting everything.
Because the case
we're not protesting about anything.
Era where they apparently had more
because
income.
Because they found him easier, because he wasn't coming down on people like that. But now you speak a different language to what is being spoken right now, and you don't know where you're going to end up.
My own bigger cake starts with you start showing us cutbacks. You start showing us greater creativity with the way you manage our income, and then we're ready to talk about bigger cake coming from us.
The truth is, bigger cake does not have to start from taxing the masses. Mm-hmm. It has to start from the top.
Yes.
If you take an economy like the United States, the top 1% pay close to 40% of the entire tax.
That's still tax.
1%.
Yeah.
And then this amount that this 1% pay is bigger than what 90% bottom pays.
Mm-hmm. So you're talking about the Dangotes and the...
So the top earners need to pay first.
Absolutely.
They need to take a fair share of the burden. Mm. Then the second part is we need to bring in more people into the tax net and improve collection. See, there are instances of even deductions from staff salary that are never remitted. Mm. In Lagos State, on the books in Lagos State, there are only 770,000 taxpayers. Can we get more people to feel participatory? But that is also a junction where there's some problems. Because the reason people don't feel good about paying taxes is that they've not seen what the little...
Absolutely.
Yes. So we need to build a trust. We need to build a trust. So why we're even saying, okay, we have come into the 2020 budget, which is a paltry amount. It's ridiculous. There's nothing we can bake with that budget.
Mm. Okay,
No, I mean, as far as I'm concerned, it was a few years ago that I wrote an article that Nigeria is broke, and that was during Good Luck Jonathan's whatever, and that he's just trying to play the artful dodger, and nothing is going to come of it. And so, whether you kick him out, bring in this new man, nothing is going to happen. I think we're in serious trouble.
I think
because we have nowhere to go, nowhere to hide, nowhere to run, and nowhere to hide.
Well, I think it's a matter of leadership, isn't it?
Yeah.
As was rightly pointed out by Bolahan, in westernized countries, it's the top 1% that pay the most tax. Mm-hmm. But the reality is that the ordinary people, so to speak, are willing to pay tax because you can see what your money is being used for. I am based in the UK. Mm-hmm. You have electricity round the clock. You have running water round the clock.
Good roads. You have
good roads, infrastructure, etc. Sometimes I complain that I pay so much tax, but at the end of the day, I can see the benefit. Mm. However, as been rightly pointed out, it's very difficult to mobilize the people to pay taxes when they can't see the benefits. Mm-hmm. I've just had a nightmare since I came into the country last week with the state of our roads and how a journey that should take 15 minutes is taking 4 hours.
Welcome home.
Yeah, welcome.
Yeah, but like I say, human resource, if we can invest in, like, I like what the comparisons you made, very enlightening, that South Africa, 10 trillion, their education budget is the entire budget for the country. But actually, when I read up, South Africa, their education budget is way above America and UK, so they're progressive.
They're doing
an aggressive agenda. Yeah, they're investing in their people now. Correct. And hopefully we'll see the dividends in the future. Mm. You know, so what are we doing about our population that people are, you know, should be the envy of the world? Mm. How are we investing in them?
A population that should be an asset for us has become a liability. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Other countries with the size of people that we have are using it to turn the turbines.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
It's a weight sitting on it.
Well, if you don't invest in education.
There's no point crying over spilt milk, they say. Chuka, it's not so much crying as calling out for change after the break.